Are you one of those people who can fall asleep on a plane before it's even taken off? Not me. I think most of us can use some help in this department, and that's exactly what this video is about. I'm going to share with you tips and tricks on how to sleep on a plane, so keep watching. If you're new to Top Flight Family, my name is Carmen. We are the Sognonvi family, and we are all about inspiring families to explore the world together in comfort and style. We share tips on how you can save time, reduce hassle, and maximize comfort when you travel with kids. So if that sounds good to you, please subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss our next video. Also, be sure to follow us on Instagram at Top Flight Family. Okay, so how can you get some sleep on a plane? Here are my top tips. Number one, maximize your leg room. If you're feeling cramped, it's gonna be really hard to fall asleep, especially if you're gonna be stuck that way for a while. Obviously, you'll get the best sleep by flying first or business class in one of those sweet lie flat seats, but that's not going to be an option for everyone or for every flight. But that doesn't mean that you're completely out of options. If you're flying economy, for example, look into how much it would cost to upgrade to premium economy, where the seats are a bit wider and you have more leg room. You'd be surprised by how affordable it can be, as low as just $20 or $30 more, and the extra room is gonna make a big difference in helping you sleep. If upgrading to a better class isn't an option and you have to fly coach, choose the emergency exit row, which always has more leg room. Now, one drawback here though is that kids aren't allowed to sit in these rows, so the rest of your family will have to sit elsewhere. Another tip I have is to take a look at the seat map of the specific plane you're flying on a site like Seat Guru or Seat Expert, to see if there's any economy seats that have extra leg room because of how the cabin is configured. When we flew to Dubai, for example, it was on an Airbus A380 operated by Emirates. And on this plane, there are 4 seats in the economy cabin that have tons of extra leg room because it's by an emergency exit with no seat in front of it. So even though it was a 14 or 15 hour flight in economy, my husband Serge was able to stretch out his legs and be really comfortable, and it didn't cost us anything extra. Number two, dress for comfort. If you want to sleep on a plane, you should wear comfortable clothes, preferably loose fitting and nothing that's too constricting around the waist. There's plenty of athleisure wear on the market now, so this doesn't mean that you have to completely forego style or look sloppy. Whatever you choose, you can't go wrong with soft, breathable, natural fabrics like cotton or silk. It's also a good idea to dress in layers because the temperature in airline cabins can kind of go up and down pretty drastically. So you wanna be able to take off an outer layer or add an outer layer if you get cold. For long haul flights, our girls will actually just wear pajamas to the airport and on the airplane. Then when we land at our destination, they change into regular clothes before we head to the hotel. Oh, and always wear socks, not ankle socks, but ones that are long enough to cover the ankle because there can often be cold drafts near the floor. Even better, wear compression socks because they help prevent blood clots and also can help reduce the swelling in your feet and ankles that can happen from a long flight. Number three, power down your devices. Blue light from screens has been shown to disrupt your ability to fall asleep. So it's a good idea to start powering down those devices anywhere from 30 to 60 minutes before you're planning to go to sleep. When it comes to kids, tell them that they get to watch shows for a certain amount of time, and after that, they have to do something that doesn't involve screens for 30 to 60 minutes, like coloring or reading a physical book. That will also help calm them down and get them ready for sleep. By the way, if you'd like to get a free copy of my guide, The 10 Travel Products That Every Family Should Own, just go to topflightfamily.com/travel and enter your email address. I'm gonna link this below as well. Okay, here's my next tip. Number four, take melatonin. Okay, so I guess this is where I should remind you that I am not a healthcare professional, so you should always consult with your doctor first, but our family has felt completely safe taking melatonin. Melatonin is a hormone that your body naturally produces around bedtime. You can get natural melatonin supplements at just about any drugstore. Ideally, you want to take the proper dosage 20 to 30 minutes before sleep, and it's also going to help you manage jet lag by helping to regulate your sleep when you get to your destination. Our girls love taking melatonin gummies, which they call their sleep vitamins. By the way, if you're tempted to drug your kids with something like Benadryl before a flight, think again. Benadryl can sometimes have an energizing effect on kids so that it actually makes them more hyper instead of making them drowsy. So you're much better off sticking to the natural stuff like melatonin that has no crazy side effects. Okay, while we're talking about substances that can mess with your sleep, here's a few more things to keep in mind. Number five, avoid sugar, caffeine, and alcohol. These stimulants can really interfere with your sleep, so try to avoid them when you fly. And they can also prevent you from being fully hydrated, and dehydration is another thing that has been shown to disrupt sleep. Now remember that whatever affects us as adults can affect our kids too. So limit your kids' sugar intake the day you fly and it'll be easier for them to calm down. Number 6, fasten your seatbelt over your blanket. Okay, it's taken you hours, but you've finally fallen asleep. Next thing you know, the flight attendant is waking you up, telling you to fasten your seatbelt because there's turbulence ahead. The only problem is your seatbelt was already fastened. It was just under the blanket. If you want to avoid this annoying scenario, fasten your seatbelt over your blanket. So that way, flight attendants will see that you're safe and won't wake you. While I'm mentioning blankets, number 7, bring your own blanket. The blankets that you get on a plane are not always the most clean or the most comfortable, so it's a good idea to bring your own. You can also use a big shawl or a big scarf for this purpose. You're best off buying a travel blanket that's specifically designed for people who are bringing them on planes. Regular blankets are going to be way too bulky, especially if you're flying carry-on only, which, if you've been watching our videos for a while, you should know that I believe everyone should be doing. I recently bought this travel blanket from Amazon that's super thin and it rolls easily into this very compact pouch. There's a whole world of travel blankets out there, so you should really see what different kinds you can get and see which will best fit your needs. Some come with pouches that you can put your feet into to keep those cozy. Others come with a poncho style opening that you can put over your head so it won't slip off your shoulders. There are all kinds of ingenious solutions out there, so take some time to find the right travel blanket for you and your family. My next tip has to do with location, location, location. Number 8, take the window seat. If you want to sleep on a plane, this is definitely the best seat to pick. First of all, you have a wall to lean on, which makes it easier to sleep. And unlike with the middle or the aisle seat, no one will have to wake you up when they need to go to the bathroom. And you won't get bumped by the drinks cart as it goes down the aisle either. Also, choose a seat in the middle of the cabin as it's usually more quiet there. Try to avoid the front or the back of the cabin because those areas tend to be the busiest and noisiest because there are usually people gathered waiting for the bathroom or getting drinks or snacks from the galleys. Next, use the universal symbol for do not disturb. Number 9, wear a sleeping mask. The more light that you can block out, the better you're gonna sleep. And on flights, there's often unexpected light, like if someone suddenly opens a window and it's blindingly bright outside, or if they turn on the plane lights in the cabin to serve a meal, but you would rather sleep through it. Standard sleep masks work fine, but I actually prefer sleep masks that have contoured eye cups so that there's a bit of space between the mask and your eye. Traditional masks rest directly on your eyelid, so they're a little bit different. The contoured versions I find to be more comfortable, and they also allow the eyes to flutter while you sleep. Number 10, wear earplugs or noise-canceling headphones. If there's a loud talker or a crying baby in your cabin, that is not exactly going to help you get good sleep, so block them out. Standard foam earplugs help some, but if you want something more effective, get some custom earplugs made out of silicone. They block more sound and don't fall out of your ears the way foam ones do. Noise-canceling headphones are also a great option. I have a pair of Bose noise-canceling headphones that are, no joke, like 15 years old, but they still work like a dream, and I feel super unhip wearing them, but hey, quality's quality, right? Serge has a much newer pair of noise-canceling headphones. These are from Sony, and he absolutely loves them. They're great because they're Bluetooth-enabled, so you can use them as wireless headphones, but they also come with a cord so that you can easily plug them into the in-flight entertainment system on your flight and use them to watch movies on the plane. To take it up a notch, you can download a white noise machine on your phone to play on the headphones while you sleep. Number 11, use a neck pillow. Neck pillows definitely help you sleep, but not in the way that you might think. I don't know about you guys, but if I'm sleeping on a plane, my head will often drop forward suddenly, and that's the thing that wakes me up. So instead of wearing my neck pillow the traditional way, I actually turn it around so that my chin rests on the front and it won't drop. I'm gonna link to the neck pillow that I use down below, and one of the reasons that I love it is because it has a fastener that connects the two ends of the U-shape so that when you have it turned around, it's not gonna slip off your neck. Number 12, be okay with not getting amazing sleep. It's really hard to fall asleep when you're stressing about how important it is for you to fall asleep, so just chill out. You may not get great, if any, sleep on a flight, and that's okay, because sometimes just taking the time to rest and close your eyes and relax is helpful enough. Okay, if you want to see the 5 things that I never fly without, just click below and I will see you over there in that video. Thanks for watching.